Hey, what's up? It's always me, Johnny, and today we are gonna talk about some useful and interesting apps that I use on my phone. I'm just thinking to start a series about some apps that you can download on your phone too. So let me know down below if you are interested into this series, so I will be doing maybe some other videos. But let's start with this one. So, welcome back to this video. I have right here my Mi 11, so you have seen it already because I've done also another video on this channel to show you some of the best hidden feature that you can find on this phone actually. And today we are gonna see some apps that you can use on Android, and most of these apps are probably compatible also with iOS, but not all of that, because we will start with the first one, that it is a custom launcher. So this one, I think for sure it is not supported by iOS, so you cannot install this one on iPhones, of course, but I just found it that it is a very, very fun app to use. Not necessarily useful, but I pretty much enjoy it while I was using it. And I am talking about the computer launcher too, that it is pretty much a launcher that just transform your smartphone into a computer, pretty much. So you will see an interface as it was on Windows 11, actually. So it's pretty new and it is free. So if you want to try it, just search on the Play Store this computer launcher and you can try it right now. So let's go into the application and let's see how it is. So as you can see, also the loading, it is pretty cool. And actually you will have the same wallpaper, of course, that you have on your phone. That will be the only thing that doesn't change. You will have a very new interface. So this is pretty much Windows, as you can see. And as you can see down there, you have the application bar. So you have also the notification center. It is not precise on the screen. I mean, you can see that it is going like off the screen right here, but it is still working pretty good. Also, you have some of the most used app that you have right here on the phone. You have the search bar from Google. You have a timer with also the calendar and also the battery. Of course, you can also download some other themes on here because you have the theme app integrated into this launcher. But let's see how it is practically. So you can hit right here the start button, as we can do it also on Windows, of course. It is pretty much with the glass design that you can find on Windows 11. So very, very cool, actually. And also right here, as I said before, you have the notification center and also the quick settings, that all of that are working pretty good. Maybe sometimes here and there is something that it is not working perfectly, but it is a very unique and stylish design. So a very cool launcher to install. So free to download. If you want to try it, just download it from the Play Store. Second app that we are gonna see, it is called Battery Indicators Free. And so what it does, you can see it also right there around the camera, the front camera hole. And it is a battery bar that you can activate from here. For example, I just activated it because I think it's cool around the camera circle. It is not perfect because it does collide just a little bit with the time, but you can just adjust it. And you can also animate that bar while you are charging the phone. And also you can activate the battery bar that it is on the top right here. So as you can see it, there is a bar right there. And you can of course just edit some settings right here. So the thickness of the bar and the transparency and all of that. You can also change the position. You can put it pretty much anywhere you want. And also you can change the color, of course. Also you can enable the battery text that you can put pretty much anywhere, as all the other settings. And it is a pretty cool application that it is of course free, as it says in the name. There is also a paid version of this without the ad. And also you can do some other stuff. So you can check your battery info. You can change the animation while you're charging your phone. So a lot of things for a free application. So just try it. Then another interesting application that I use very much, very often, it is the Share IT Lite. This is the Lite version, but there are a lot of versions of this application. You can install pretty much whatever you want. This is for just sharing files from a device to another, and it doesn't count if it is not like Android or it is not Windows or any other operating system. You just install this application on both of the devices and you can just send and receive files without any problem and very, very fast. This is a very useful application that I use pretty much every day because it's so useful. For the fourth app, we have Foursquare. I don't know if you are familiar with this application, and I suggest to use this application while you are traveling, if you are traveling a lot maybe. So this application gives you a lot of tips on where you go when you are around the world. And so you have different options, like here you can see breakfast, you can see lunch, dinner, coffee and tea, nightlife, but also you can see things to do in a new city. Maybe you don't know where you have to go for lunch. You just hit lunch and you just type your location, or maybe you just enable the location settings on your phone and then it just finds everything that you need for that city. So for example, I will type right here, just Rome, for example. So we just hit Rome and you can find anything. So the things to do, things to where to go to eat, you can just filter for price for the places to be like just open and not the closed one. So you can just save your favorites, you can like all of this stuff right here. So there are a lot of filters, and as I said before, it is very useful. Also, you can just hit one of these attractions, for example, and you can see also the likes, you can see some photos, you can see some comments on the attraction, for example, but also of course you can use that for things to eat, so you can see some reviews and all of that stuff. Very, very useful. It has pretty much anything that you need when you are traveling. Another app very useful when you are traveling, and if you like to take some photos or maybe videos, it is Photo Time. That it tells you exactly when and where the sun is gonna come out or maybe go down, so you don't have to worry about the time and the position of the sun. And also you can get right here, so the blue hour, the sunrise, the golden hour, the sunset, so a lot of stuff, and you have it day by day, so you just select your location and you're good to go pretty much. And also you have a 3D map of the sun position, so you will find it like in real time. Very, very useful, and it is working actually pretty good. And also you can see the position of the moon, because right here you have also the moon setting, but of course you have to unlock it and also you have to pay for that. I'm not interested into that because I'm not doing like night photography, but I just use the sun function. So for example, I can go here on the map, I can just hit a point and it says just precisely when it's gonna go down the sun and when it's gonna come up. So very, very useful. Also there is a line for the golden hour and blue hour if you want. That's very, very useful if you are just doing photography, as I said before, or maybe if you want to just see some sunset and some sunrise maybe. So the last application, it is very known in the photography world again, because this is Snapseed, and this is a very, very complete app to just edit your photos. I don't use like Lightroom Mobile or any of that stuff. I just use Snapseed if I have to edit some photos, because you have some presets, you can just create presets or maybe download it from the internet, or maybe you can just edit your photos with all of these settings that are a lot for a mobile application, and they are working very, very good. It is a very powerful app if you need to do like some fly edit on the go. This one is the app that I use every time. So those were the main applications that I wanted to show you on this video. So I hope you found them somewhat useful or maybe just fun to use. And I hope you liked this video. If you did, just hit a like down below because it's free. And also let me know down below in the comments if you like this type of videos. Maybe if I should do another video like that for some of the best application, maybe weekly or maybe monthly, so I will find some interesting and fun application, or maybe just some games to play on your phone. Just let me know it down below in the comments. And also don't forget to subscribe right now if you haven't already. And thank you for watching this video, and I think I will see you in my next one. Bye for now.